Okay. I'll be common folk. You are our guest.
The
so,
now, yeah.
VIP. Ni sawa, tumekubali kukua common folk. Ninajua mahali penye nitazitisha zote leo. Anyway, our first guest is in studio and he goes by the name Vosti. We'll be getting to know more about him, mahali anatoka, what kind of music he does, and yeah, just get to feel his vibe. Karibu sana kwenye show.
Asante sana, nashukuru. Niko poa. Yes.
So kindly jiintroduce majina yako ya usanii, majina ya national ID na utuambie umetoka mtaa gani.
So national ID naitwa Steven Irongo Karenga. Jina ya usanii ni Vosti. Vosti with I3 ama 111. So that's what it means. It's just 111 but Vosti in I3. Yeah, so that's my name.
That's your name, yes.
Yes. It doesn't have a meaning. It's just Stevo Vosti.
Ni
vile simple boy alikuwa ashachukua Stevo. So you can't.
So aunge aunge chukua
tena. So ni ka reverse to Vosti. Alafu nikaongezea I3.
Yeah. So umetoka gani?
I'm from Dagoretti South 111. Yes.
Okay. So
born and bred.
Born and bred.
Yes.
All right. So umekuwa ukifanya music for how long and what kind of music do you do?
I do rap, hip hop music, but niko versatile.
Yeah.
I can neza fanya ata benga. I'm joking. Sijai jaribu benga. I can try it. You never know.
Yeah.
But I do hip hop rap music. Yes.
Yes. Umekuwa ukifanya music for how long?
Nimekuwa nikifanya music since 2016. I started recording in 2016 and then I stopped recording for a while. But now I'm back recording again. So I started in 2016. I stopped for a few 3 years, let's say 2016, 17, and 18, and then now I came back 2019, and I'm now fully doing music.
Fully doing music. So in those 3 years, then you will take a break for whatever reasons that you took a break for. Do you feel like ilikurudisha nyuma kiusani?
Yes, I would say, you know, as an artist, you need to be always working on your craft, always honing your craft.
Yeah.
And so when you don't have time to work on your craft, it takes like a toll. It goes down kidogo. Your skill level will not be as good as someone who has been working all the time.
Yes.
Yeah. So the time I took a break, I was working. So when I started music, a little bit about myself, I noticed that you can't music is expensive and you can't just create music and then have it in the house.
Yeah.
You need to record it so that people can listen to it and so that people can see it. And so I had to find a way to record the music and so that people can see it. And the only way was working and making money so that you can find the money to record. Because going to people and asking for handouts, it's a way, but it's not the... Yes, so I had to work, but now I'm just back doing music. Yes.
So eventually, from now henceforth, you want to do music full time.
Yes, that's my passion. That's my calling. That's what I want to do. Nothing else.
So far, what challenges have you had in the last few years?
Many challenges as a new artist. First of all, like getting interviewed. I know I called you guys like 15 times. you know, it's normal challenges that people get, that new artists get. It's not different from any other artist. So
you're saying like challenges when you umepatana nazo are the same challenges that an artist mwenye anajulikana anapitia.
Yes, but now as a young unknown artist, unajua artist mwenye anajulikana, he can go somewhere, his name is already known.
Yes.
So your name can precede you, your reputation can get you into doors that I can't get
you
into.
Can't.
Even if I'm as talented as you are, you're already known. Someone knows you, he can recognize whoever you are and whatever you do from just looking at you. So you can get more opportunities than me who's not known. So let's say if artist who's not known, the not being known is the biggest
challenge.
Yeah, jisawa sio kisha kujua, baso anajua ule ni Vosti, anafanyanga music. So it's easy to relate, it's easy when they see you, even somewhere at a show, when you call them, they can come.
They'll come.
Yeah,
okay.
So those are the challenges. Okay. Normal challenges, but sasa ziko more
magnified,
gratified.
Yes.
Yeah, ju ni when hakuna mtu anakujua, you don't have
kweli.
Yeah.
Ni inspirations, uli draw inspirations zako za music from wasani kama nani?
I would say my biggest inspiration was Giuliani. Giuliani, because when he came out, I was beginning to know myself.
Yeah.
So I could relate to whatever he was saying, and I could understand, and I could digest it, and just naelewa, like naelewa kenye umse anasema. So it made me love music, and it made me want to be like him, and want to do like him, and want someone else to listen to me and understand me.
Yeah.
So yeye ndo alikuwa my biggest influence. I used to rap like him, like nilianza kumcopy. So, and then uko flani mau mau. Yeah. I think it should be the other way around, but I knew Giuliani first before I knew uko flani mau mau. I knew them, but I was not very much, you know, they were not my generation. I could say when Giuliani was starting, that's when I was like 14, 15 years old. That's when your identity starts to, unaanza kujijua kama mtu. So that's the biggest influence in my music, Giuliani and uko flani mau mau. I would say sasa kuna new influence akina Nyashinski, Calligraph. Everyone has something in his skill level that you can just take from it and make it your own. Yeah, so
music yako, you want to tell stories. Why is it that you want to write your music and sing your music in that way, like you're telling stories?
Because there's so many stories that need to be told from the ghetto and from everywhere, not just the ghetto.
Yeah.
There are so many things going on, and artists need to talk about it. We need to say something about tunafaa kuongelelea kenye inaendelea kwa streets, kwa society. Kama watu wanakoniwa, kama watu wanaibiwa, just say it like the real thing, whatever is going on in the society. Yeah. We need to tell the stories. Na story ndio inafanyanga msee akusikize. Like, you can't just go talk to someone and start talking, you need to tell him a story. This is how it started, and then it went this, alafu ikaisha. So that's the best way to tell your narrative through a story.
Through music,
so that's, like, I would say, nikachi, najaribu ku use the easiest way to communicate. That's telling stories.
Okay.
Yeah, so najaribu kuambia wasee kenye inaendelea through stories and through music.
Ngoma zenye umefanya so far, you've collaborated with other hip-hop artists in the industry.
Yes.
So, why did you particularly choose mtu kama Breeder na?
First of all, Breeder, nilikuwa na mwatch for a very long time. And I see a lot of myself in him. Tuko almost the same age. We grew up the same place.
Okay.
So I used to see him grow up, tukicheza FIFA in the same area. So I used to, like, I saw his hustle and I saw him go rise up. So I wanted to show that and to have him in my soul. Like, it was just ni kama ile lazima nikuwe na umse kwa ngoma yangu. It was not like calculated or anything. It was just that I like him. I like his music. I like the way he sounds. So I wanted to have him in my music. Yeah, so the same with Boutros. And they were nice guys, man. You know, you see them on TV and you think maybe atakuwa na attitude or anything. Ni wase tu wapoa, mnabonga, tukabonga. We spoke about the song and whatever I wanted to do. And they understood. And they both are professional. Nani wasi wanajua tu kenye wanadu. So walini inspire pia hao. Walini onesha, like, this is how you do it. This is how you move.
Like wamekushika mkono.
Yeah. You see, when you're with people who are doing the same thing, the same line of work, wanaweza kufu. Like, if you're friends, we uwezi niambia anything about music, like, do this, write this, and do this. But if I'm a friend with someone who makes music the same as I, if I make a mistake, anaweza niambia, mama hii chorus. Yeah, just remove this word. Yes, yeah, yes, and put another word that makes more sense and makes it even more appealing.
Okay.
Yeah.
So, ni ngoma gani umetuletea leo, like the song you're pushing right now?
I have a new song. Inaitwa Outstanding.
Okay.
It's on YouTube. You guys can go check it out.
And that's what you've done alone. It's a solo project.
Yes, it's a single release. Ni single tu, ni ngoma moja. Yes.
So, concept yake ilikuwa nini?
Actually, the chorus is in Kikuyu. Ni enekekeu. So it's like, what is it? What are you? Who are you? It's like I'm explaining myself. It's like my bio. I'm explaining myself. This is who I am, and this is what I do. Yeah.
You, it's not the only one in Kikuyu. There's another one is in Kikuyu.
Yes, Kwanini yes, yes.
You like throwing?
I believe that music ni like language. It gonna skill. It gonna certain skill to it. So if you know a language, if like I know Kikuyu, I know Swahili, yes. I know Sheng.
Mm-hmm.
So when I'm writing, mm-hmm. I will use every tool I have to write so that the song can sound better and the song can sound good.
Mm-hmm.
So if a little bit of Kikuyu here and there, itafanya song ikue poa and I sound smart. Inaweko, yeah. So that's how you create. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, ukijieka kwa box that you only rap in English, mm-hmm. I only rap in Swahili.
Mm-hmm.
Then what to najeo kimwambia I only listen to English raps. So what will you
kama calligraph.
Yeah, lazima kuwe versatile. Uh-huh. So if I knew Spanish, ingekuwa hapo pia. If I knew Kisi uh-huh. and everything.
Yani utaki kujilimit. Apana. You have, you're using it to
like
make
I said from
better.
The beginning, I'm versatile.
Yes.
So
okay.
If
right.
versatility mm-hmm. makes you open to anything. And mm-hmm. I keep an open mind every mm-hmm. time I'm creating music. Kwa sababu creation ni creation. You're creating from nowhere. You're mm-hmm. just taking words and making them into a song.
Okay.
So if the words make the song better,
mm-hmm.
then
so be
yeah, but I was a little bit nikuwa muoga kwa sababu.
About you the know, Kikuyu.
Yeah, when you put a language that not everyone can speak and not mm-hmm. everyone can understand,
mm-hmm.
uko na ile fear like James mwingine akisikia.
Yeah.
So uh-huh. it was
but
there a little bit.
But zinitongwa reggaeton and all other songs from hata unaweza sikiza ngoma ya Kijaluo and still vibe to it.
Yeah, yeah. So but it's a double edged sword.
Yeah.
Yeah, inaweza kusaidia
na
baadaye inaweza
kuluzisha. Yes.
Yeah, so okay. It depends. Hmm. Whatever happens, you never know when you create a song, you just make it with the vibe and hujui vile wasi watareact.
Yeah.
So when you put it out, that's when you see mm-hmm. the reaction mm-hmm. and it has been positive, it mm-hmm. has been good reaction so mm-hmm. far, so I can't complain.
Okay, all right. So before we wind up, mm-hmm. ningetaka you share your social media handles, mahali watu wanaweza pata your music,
yes.
yeah, and future projects.
So my on YouTube ni Vosti,
mm-hmm.
VOSTIII. Alafu on Facebook ni Vosti, kuna fan page Vosti. And then on Facebook, the personal page ni Vosti Wadago. Na on Instagram is Vosti,
mm-hmm.
the same spelling, VOSTIII.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
All right, so thank you so much for coming through.
Thank you so much too for having
me. We appreciate
your time. Nashukuru pia.
We hope to see you more once you
I hope to come
projects.
Here even more.
You're welcome.
More projects.
Karibu sana pani nyumbani.
Thank you.
Kama kawaida, we support upcoming artists. Ever so long as they are doing Kenyan music. So nataka tusikize inaitwa
outstanding.
Yes, sorry about that, but yeah, that was Vosti. Vile amekwambia, you need to be versatile. Usijifungie kwa box moja. Go out there and do your thing. So up next is challenge outstanding. Outstanding, sorry, by Vosti.